have made it their mission to stop animal abuse in circuses. This relentless British couple sends teams to infiltrate circuses around the world to document the mistreatment of animals. Their work helped lead to local laws banning most wild animals from circuses in more than 15 U.S. states and to national bans in more than 20 countries. As we first reported in March, their latest successes have been across South America, where they spent years recording animal cruelty on hidden cameras. We caught up with Jan and Tim in Peru, along with 24 lucky lions they'd recently rescued from traveling circuses. A warning, some of the pictures later in this report are disturbing. These caged lions have never had it so good. They got to this temporary rescue center thanks to the unrelenting efforts of Jan Creamer and Tim Phillips and members of the organization they founded, Animal Defenders International. Creamer and Phillips told us all 24 lions here had been repeatedly beaten in traveling circuses. The lions sounded like they wanted to tell us themselves.
Hold on, just 1 second.
This was the first time we had an interview, interrupted by Rory.
This is their morning song?
Morning song.
If it was you or I, it'd be, where the hell's my coffee?
I do sound like that when I haven't had my coffee.
Jan and Tim rescue more than lions. They launched their South America campaign after seeing a chimpanzee named Toto chained outside a circus in Chile.
They'd smashed his teeth to punish him. They were stabbing cigarettes out on him.
Jan shot that picture and he just gazed across at the Andes. It almost looked like he was looking mournfully at what he'd lost. Mm. We're determined to rescue him. And we took him all the way home to Africa.
A judge, appalled by Toto's treatment, had given custody to Jan and Tim.
Our role is to take them from where they are, where they're suffering, put them where they need to be.
In South America, their team recorded this hidden camera footage of abuse, which is hard to watch.
What we did was we put a team undercover inside the South American circuses. And they stayed there for almost 2 years, just gathering evidence, filming, photographing. So you're living in the heart of the circus, but that's how you get the really amazing evidence.
Many of their pictures were taken by undercover cameraman Alexis Diaz. When circus workers discovered what he was doing, they beat him up and broke his leg. Still, he kept working to collect evidence.
Lots of our evidence has been used by prosecutors for cruelty convictions. Just one beating of an animal isn't going to secure a conviction. You have to show a pattern of behavior.
Some circuses claim they train wild animals without abuse, using food and positive reinforcement. But Creamer and Phillips insist beatings are routine, because performing tricks is unnatural for wild animals. They only comply out of fear.
If you've got a dangerous animal, that means subjugation.
Subjugation means beating.
Absolutely. It's all about control and how they're going to make it do what they want it to do. So it's a kick, it's a punch, it's a beating.
And really, we've seen that everywhere we've gone.
This everywhere?
Yeah, in Europe, in America, in South America. There are certain consistencies in the way that these circus animals are looked after.
Using violence is the way that these animals are made to do things that they don't want to do. They don't want to get up and perform. So they have to force them to do it.
So when you made this video evidence public, what was the reaction?
The reaction was instant. I mean, it really was just outrage. And then the politicians were starting to hear about it and say, well, we should probably have legislation here.
Bolivia was the first country in South America to ban wild animal acts. Other countries have followed suit?
Absolutely. Colombia, Peru, there's over 30 countries.
But in Peru, the new law led to their next challenge, enforcement. Lion acts were outlawed, but local police were not equipped to pick up the lions or care for them. So Jan and Tim said their organization would take in the lions. They brought police for protection during the seizures.
Eso es un abuso lo que hacen ustedes.
Because the circuses resisted handing over their money makers.
Yeah, they threatened to release the animals into the streets.
Seriously, to let wild animals run through the streets if you come down hard on them.
That's right.
When they raided the circus in Cusco, Peru, they rescued three lions, but the circus refused to release its star attraction, a lion named Smith. The circus demanded police get another court order for Smith. While Jan and Tim worked on that, Smith had to keep performing.
He was unstable and upset because his family had been broken up.